Hi there, it's Freeman Stephen. It is Sunday, the 22nd of June 2014. Look what I found. Wolfsbane, or more specifically, Aconitum napellus, also known as Monk's Hood and Friar's Cowl. The reason it's called that is because this bit at the top, which you can lift and an anther will pop out. Looks like the cowl of a friar or the hood of a monk. So it's called Friar's Cowl or Monk's Hood, and it's a type of wolfsbane, or debatably, you could say that wolfsbane is limited to the mountainous variety, but there is a type of aconitum, and virtually it's used for the same things. What is it actually used for? So the most historic use has been as like poison for catching animals and stuff like that, and also as an ointment for flying ointment, as the witches called it in pagan times. They would basically make a salve out of the plant, especially the roots, but also the leaves and the flowers. If you've ever seen the buttercups, known as the aconite leaf buttercup, it's because they've got leaves shaped like this. This is the leaves of Aconitum napellus, and that's why aconite leaf buttercups are called aconite leaf buttercups, because their leaves look like aconites, surprisingly enough. So what witches would do is they would crush these into like a green mush, and then mix them with lard. And they would basically apply it to their extremities to absorb the alkaloids which are within it, and those alkaloids would give them a sensation of flying. Now the thing about the alkaloids is that the alkaloids can be absorbed through the skin. And that's why they were applying these to like their extremities and kind of bits of their flesh, like their lips and stuff like that. But it can also be absorbed through skin. So if you're ever going to like industrially harvest this stuff, it's probably good to wear protective gear to prevent yourself being affected by the plant's potency. The plant is so potent that 20 milligrams of the alkaloids, or 1 or 2 grams of the plant being ingested or consumed, produces the effect of being dead. So it is deadly poisonous. It's one of the most deadly poisonous plants that grow. There's a lot of stuff all round about is that you can some of it nutritious, some of it not nutritious, but very little of it is actually deadly poisonous. This is one of the most deadly poisonous, besides things like hemlock. And it's also a kind of potent entheogen as well, which means it has like it has like neurological effects too, but people tend not to use it because of the dangers of being killed by it, and it's probably more potent, more dangerous than other entheogenic plants such as henbane or mandrake or Brugmansia datura. Belladonna, those type of plants. Wolfsbane is an entire different group of plants altogether, which also have entheogenic uses. As well as that, there's also medicinal uses for treating heart complaints and stuff like that. But because of the toxic effects, the pharmaceutical industry stayed away from using these plants in preference to using things like foxglove, the digitalin plant, to produce the drugs which can ease heart complaints and stuff like that. So it has been used medicinally in the past, but generally people stay away from it because it is so deadly toxic. So that is wolfsbane, or more specifically, monk's hood. Sometimes the name wolfsbane is reserved for the mountain variety, which is yellow flowers. But a lot of people just describe monkshood as being wolfsbane because it is very similar, not so much to look at, but considering the kind of stuff that's inside the plant. Now, I personally don't know how to use this plant medicinally, but maybe at some stage I will be able to do that. So I've brought a plant to kind of have a kind of locally grown set of wolfsbane going about. I've just hung it upside down to dry, but that's what it looks like, and it grows in kind of clumps with these racemes, so there's like several of these. But maybe the light's not too good in here to see it, but you get the idea. So I don't know how to use it. There's lots of plants that I know are medicinal, and I do try to collect them and kind of have them growing round about where I live, but I don't exactly know how to use it yet, so I'm not going to even attempt to use it, because this specific wolfsbane thing is not only like medicinal, not only entheogenic, but also used as a thing for like killing animals. What they used to do was make a mush out of it and tip their arrows with it so that they would kill animals like for hunting and stuff like that, and it was said to, like in wars and stuff like that, it was said to drive enemies mad before they died, so that could be the neurological effects, or maybe the entheogenic effects of the plant as it was used to kill people. So what I'm saying is it's a very, very dangerous plant. But it does have uses, so I'm going to try and have just a wee bit of cultivating of it. Not so much cultivating, but I'd like to have some wild monkshood growing about here, just to go along with all the other kind of things that I've been bringing here, like the water mint and the other plants that I've kind of like popped up through me collecting bits and pieces and dropping them here. So that's my wolfsbane video, most poisonous plant that I've got. Well, it's not the most poisonous there is, but it's one of the most poisonous there is, so like, don't try this at home. You'll notice that I'm handling it with my hands, and that is a very bad thing to do, especially if you're going to be harvesting lots of this stuff, because the alkaloids in that can seep through the skin and cause the effects of the plant to take hold of you. So that is my latest plant video. Freeman, Stephen out.